Welcome dear students for the first part of our new lesson of history, lesson number 2, history and the concept of time. This will be the first part of our discussion. In few more parts we'll be covering the lesson. This is the revision part 1. Okay, so we have here a picture of day and night. The day is divided into 12 hours, day and night. So earth day is divided into day and night. So why it is happening day and night? Because if you know, want to know the concept of time, you should know first what, how the day is counted, how days are counted and how we should count them. So this is the reason why we have day and night. The reason is earth's rotation. What is that? Earth's rotation. Okay, you know that earth is rotating. Rotating means moving. Earth is moving, and because of earth's moving, half part of the earth is getting sunlight. Look, for example, sunlight, sun is here this side and the earth is this side. The earth is moving. So what is happening? Half part of this earth, whole earth, half part of the earth is getting sunlight. It's getting sunlight. That's why there is day. And the half part of the earth which is not getting the sunlight is having the day, night. This is the difference. So day and night is reason why there is a day and night, because rotation of the earth. And there is one more concept called revolution. What is that? As earth is moving around its own axis, it is also moving around the sun. The sun is at the center and the earth is moving around the sun. That is called revolution. And how much time it is taking? 365 days, sometimes 366 days. What we call is a 1 year. So that is not important for this lesson. What is important for this lesson? We have to remember the earth day is because of rotation of the earth. Means half part of the earth is getting sunlight. That's why there is a day on that part. And the half part that is not getting sunlight is, of course, night. Okay, you must have understood the difference. Okay. So, in your lesson there is one concept called unilinear division of time. What is that? Unilinear division of time. So, what is that? I will first tell. Okay, for our convenience we have divided the time into three groups. One is past, present, future, for our convenience. Okay, again we have divided the time. The day is again divided, the time is divided into micro and large groups. And this is called unilinear division of time. So, how we start counting? First we count second. Isn't it? So why second? Because you can easily visualize that second is happening. 1 second has happened. So second is converted into a minute. Isn't it? Second is converted into minute, and minute is converted into 1 hour. Isn't it? Remember the sequence. First is second. Seconds, third, 60 seconds make a minute. Again, 60 minutes make 1 hour. 1 hour. Okay. And 1 hour make, so if you collect the hours, 24 hours make 1 day. How many? 24 hours make a day. 1 day. Then, afterwards, what is there after a day? There is a combination of days and we have week afterwards. Okay, 7 days make 1 week. Then after week there is fortnight. What is fortnight? The period of 2 weeks. The time of 2 weeks or 14 or 15 days is called fortnight. What is that? Fortnight. In a month, how many fortnight will be there then? 2. Okay? A period of 14 days will be called fortnight. So remember, are you getting the sequence? Second, minute, hour, then day, then day, then week, and then fortnight. Afterwards there will be 1 month. 1 month may be of 28 days, sometimes 29 days, sometimes 30 days and 31 days. Maybe like this. Then this is the next one. And after month, what will be there? What will be there? Yes, you are right. What is that? A year. So 12 months make 1 year. Okay. So 1 year. Then we have one more term called decade. What is that? If there are 10 years, how many? 10 years. 10 years will make 1 decade. So 1 decade is of how many years? 10. Then again we have century. Century is of how many years? Century is of 100 years. Century is of 100 years. Then after century we have millennium. So what is millennium? When there are 1000 years. 1000 years make 1 millennium. So you understood this sequence. First will be second. Second is converted into minute. Minute is converted into hours. Hours is converted into day. Day is converted into week. Week is converted into fortnight. Fortnight is converted into a month. Month is converted into a year. Year is converted into decade. Decade is converted into century. And century is converted into 1 million. So how many years will be there in 1 million? 1000. Remember this. So this division of time is called unilinear division of time. I hope you must have understood. Okay. So the which is the smallest unit of the time then in this unilinear cellular? Then second. So what is that? Second is the smallest. And the largest one is millennium. It is of 1000 years. Okay. So this is the concept of unilinear time of time. So there is one more concept that is maybe a little bit confusing to you. So you pay attention carefully. Okay, so what you have to common era. So now we are saying that this is year 2020. This year 2020. Why we are saying 2020 only? Why we are not saying 2019? Why we are not saying 2021? There is reason behind it. And that reason you should know. Okay. So I will be telling you what is the reason. Okay. You know that there is one religion called Christian. And this is found in all over the world. And who founded this religion? Jesus Christ. Who found? Jesus Christ. The birth of Jesus Christ. And he, because of him, this religion has been created. Okay, so this was an important event in the whole world. What was the important event in the whole world? Birth of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was born that day. From that day, people decided that we'll start counting a calendar. We'll start making a calendar for our family, so that we can divide the days, we can divide the years. Okay, so from that day, the people have decided that we will fix a date of counting calendars. And that event, what was that event? The birth of Jesus Christ. Then, so after birth of Jesus Christ, it was considered 1 year. When he completed 1 year, the world also completed, the calendar also completed 1 year. The calendar that we have months like January, February, मार्च दिस इज अ कॉमन एरा कैलेंडर ओके दैट इज बीइंग फॉलोड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड एंड दैट हैज स्टार्टेड व्हेन इट वाज स्टार्टेड व्हेन जीसस क्राइस्ट वाज बोर्न दैट ईयर इज कंसीडर्ड फर्स्ट ईयर व्हेन ही कंप्लीटेड हिज 40 ईयर ऑफ एज द कैलेंडर आल्सो कंप्लीटेड हाउ मेनी इयर्स 40 इयर्स एज After his birth, it started. People started counting forwards. From that event, the birth of Jesus Christ has completed how many years now? Then 2020 years have been completed. 2020 years are completed after the birth of Jesus Christ. That's why this calendar is like this, and the world is following the calendar. And what about the thing which happened before his birth? Okay, the world has started from so many years. So that time is converted into BCE, before common era, or before Christ. Remember these two words. BC is what? Before Christ, Jesus Christ. And BCE, before the common era. Common era means which? When the Jesus Christ was born. From that time we started counting, that period is known as common era. The period which we started counting after the birth of Jesus Christ is known as common era. So we have common era after the birth of Jesus Christ. It is given one more name, and that name is Anno Domini, AD. AD, full form of AD is Anno Domini. Anno Domini means what? In the year of Jesus Christ, in the year of Lord. Meaning of Anno Domini is what? In the year of Lord. Okay, so this is what we are talking about. So here you have an activity to do, that you have to write the full forms of AD, BC, BC and CE. So for this I have a small video, so we'll watch that video and we'll finish here. Okay, so I will be showing the video.
Or if you're an athlete, those are negative numbers. All the years after the birth of Jesus go up. These are positive numbers. Now I know what you're thinking. What if you don't believe in JC? Well, this dating system has been the unofficial global standard for many years. The system gained popularity when Charlemagne, or his friends call him Charles the Great, began using the system to date acts of government. Although there's a new way to refer to these years, the concept behind naming the years remains rooted in religion. So what do we use now? Well, since the later part of the 20th century, the use of BCE and CE have been popularized. Authors that wanted a more secular approach to the writing began referring to the years formerly known as before Christ to BCE, which stands for before the common era. The years formerly known as ED will now be referred to as CE, which stands for the common era. More and more books and scholars are using these terms in their writings. Well, are you wrong if you use the old method? No. Since the years in both methods of labeling are equivalent, you will not be punished for using either method. Just keep in mind you may get some looks of disgust from people who have no idea what you're talking about. It happens to me a lot. So ever since the Mesopotamians, people have been keeping track of time. It wasn't until 800s that people started using the AD-BC method. Because the world was different in the 800s, our methods of labeling years have changed. For now, you're correct if you use either method of dating years. Well, that's our 5 minutes or less. Here are some sources.
Okay, so you must have understood what is BC and AD. Okay, so the next part we'll be discussing the same lesson, and if you have doubts, you can send me mail. Okay, and I will try to solve your doubts. Till then, take care. Thank you.